What if he rolls himself through all the way into second place if we see this pass? So ultimately, David McNamee is rolling so fast, and that could absolutely happen. Right now, we're looking at an almost pass. He's taking the sponges out. He's getting ready for a new aid station to get new sponges as they approach. This is the last aid station before the David Mark Hill, which summits at Polani.
All right, so as we look, Lionel Sanders knows that the inevitable moment is about to happen. He has had a gallant race all day long. Lionel has been fighting the whole way. The Canadian here, he is everything to be proud of today. Just couldn't finish and close the deal at the end here. And the pass is going to be made. Patrick Langer from Germany is going to go into first position. This is the Mark and Dave Hill. Will Patrick Langer have enough to take it to the finish line? This is going to tell right here. And look at that. There goes the pass. Patrick Langer straight away. And Sanders tries. And you know that he's going to try. Sanders is as tough as nails. You know that he's going to give everything. Patrick Langer may look over his shoulder and say, if Lionel Sanders is still there, what do I have to do to break it? But Lionel is hurting. Physically, he is done. Mentally, he's telling his body to keep going. Lionel has run a fantastic race, but now the tank is just about empty for Sanders, and Patrick Langer is absolutely flying.
And Greg, you're spot on with every second of that commentary, and let me tell you right now, the shift in the brain of Lionel Sanders needs to happen. It needs to go behind. It needs to shift. He responded to the move. It didn't work out. Now what he needs to do is he needs to look and expect that David McNamee is coming. David McNamee is still back there. He's a guy from Great Britain that has been under the radar from a lot of perspectives. He was 11th place last year. The running that he is doing today is 6:39 per mile. The estimates show him closing and finishing with Patrick Langer. So if those estimates hold true, then obviously he needs to come up and come through here very soon. Our point being, this is actually as they're dropping down and they will hit that final climb into town. This is something that could help him out. He's now latched on. Momentum-wise, he's trying to connect to that pace of Patrick Langer. You saw him suffer. He's regrouping, and I think this is one of those moments where you say, the wind is slipping, but I'm absolutely not prepared to let second place go. And if Sanders can be there, like we said, momentarily, if we could see him just momentarily say, I'm going to regroup, second place to Lionel Sanders, Matt, that tells me next year he's truly poised to get that victory. You've got to step on the podium before you win the race.
Yeah, absolutely. And you look at him and you can see kind of his profile change, and he absolutely was regrouping. You, at a certain point, you fight, and he obviously was fighting for the win and playing the cards he had left in his hand in the poker match we call Iron Man. He played those cards. Patrick had a better hand, but now he's got to regroup. He's got to settle. He's got to kind of let Patrick go, be capable of cleaning up if something happens. A cramp can happen at any time, Michael. A cramp can happen. Patrick could come back. But right now, Lionel needs to do all that he can to get his body across the line as quickly as possible to make sure he can get that second place and, as you said, build upon it for the next year.
Yeah, and the call earlier was premature, saying David Mark, but Greg, he knows those roads. Right now, I'll say what we're at is we're on the downhill,
yep.
Leading into, so that we're leading into, this is the final downhill. He's got one more uphill climb, but remember, as you just said, all that stuff you mentioned about the physical part of it, there's so much road still to go. This Eduardo de la Majoria there from Chile on the right side of the picture, I saw that bright hat, one of the top age groupers,
yeah.
Had to give a mention. He was featured by Training Peaks. Really exciting. All of a sudden, see him, there he goes, right there on the right with the bright orange cap. Phenomenal. Recapping here, what do we see? We see Sebastian Keelane. Who's chasing him down? That is David McNamee. And this is something that we didn't talk about. We didn't predict this. But right here, we're about to see fourth place jump into third place.
Yeah, absolutely. And this is an athlete that wasn't in that top 10. You know, it was someone that we thought was maybe a little bit outside. He was obviously, his gap was close enough to move up, but he knew that his best card to play was a marathon. He's holding on. He has one of the best marathons of this field, not necessarily proven in the top three in this race. He's had a great race to move up in the ranks in the past, but looking at the form of Patrick Langer, it's clear that he doesn't fade as the marathon distance improves. And then coming to Lionel Sanders, clearly biomechanically more effect from these 24 miles in him than on Patrick Lange. And another that just does not seem to be affected by this distance is David McNamee, who has passed. You can't see him in the shadow right now, but Sebastian Keenly has him passed for third place, and he right now is regrouping and trying to get to that finish line.
To me, like, he's guarding the hamstrings there, which is smart move. He didn't want to charge up that and light those hamstrings up with that hip extension, that long leg behind. It's a really smart move.
So just balancing out that form. But McNamee, I called him his 11th last year. Was wrong. It was 11th and 15th in 2015. He was 13th last year, but still 11th and 13th. Now he's just leapt right up to third place. What a breakthrough! And certainly, what a nice spot to be in. For the Brit.
No, absolutely. He's worked on his performances in the past. He's gotten experience from each of those races, and now he's obviously put himself in a podium position. And, you know, Lionel Sanders seems like he's going to be out of reach for someone like David McNamee. There's not that much ground left. But, Michael, there's a lot of downhill left. And I think what we've noticed, except from when you saw David maybe guarding his hamstrings a little bit, these two fast runners that are running through the field are rolling on these downhills. And you don't necessarily think that you can make up that much time on a downhill. But when you're 24 miles in and your competitor is cracked, you can make up 30 seconds in a half mile downhill.
Oh, the downhill is where you make the time. And I think that's exactly where a two runner, you can do it if you're powerful and you've still got a lot in the tank. An uphill is obviously a moment to pounce. But when you look at the downhills, there's certainly room to wiggle there. And so now let's look at this again. Yep. And we're showing it may be too close, 4 minutes behind. So I think that would tell most people that Sanders is safe. But we cannot say, because again, as you said, the imbalance in the regularity of his form is now exacerbated greatly by the fatigue. He's still doing what he needs to cool down. Is he getting the fluids in? I still like what I see here as far as the future of this 29-year-old Canadian. So Lionel Sanders, he's coming in here. You set foot on the podium, be it second, likely second, or a possible third. You're set in track to do what you want to do over the next 5 years.
Yeah, and you look at, if you were to ask Lionel Sanders, this is his first good race in Kona. And, he's made a big jump. Patrick's making a jump. He's likely going to go from third place to first place. But you're looking at the jump of 8, 9, 10 spots from Lionel Sanders from years past. That's a huge jump, right? So all he needs to do is move up one space next year. But right now, Michael, he looks the same as he did when he started this run. That's Patrick Lange on our screen right now. And, if anybody on the planet ran up on his shoulder, he'd have the energy to drop him right now. And it seems like for him, the run is safe. His victory is safe as long as he just keeps the legs moving over, because McNamee is too far back, and Sanders certainly does not have anything left in the tank to rival Patrick Lange.
This is the base of the climb, so this is the famous sort of famous hill that closes at the top of Palani, and obviously 1989 the Iron War was decided here. But now we're talking about 2017, many, many years down the road. Patrick Lange stamping his authority on this race, charging up this hill. The beautiful thing is here is he is a gifted runner in gorgeous form. He's going to run down the hill just as fast. Yeah. And then you get to the base of the hill, you take that left turn on the Kuakini. You still have over a mile to go. The race is far from done, but there's just more and more time put in. We're curious still how much under that barrier, that course record of 8:03:56, can Lange do? He's at 7 hours and 45 minutes at the 24. He may be right there.
He's going to be very close.
He may be at 8:05. Either way, phenomenal race.
Absolutely. And, what our predictors maybe don't take into consideration is that downhill. That's a super fast downhill. It's super fast unless you're overstriding and you maybe get a hamstring cramp. We saw Craig Alexander when he was going for that course record and got that course record. He almost came up with hamstring cramps and walked there in the final mile. So he is not slowing down on this uphill. It's going to be fantastic to see the kind of turnover he has when he turns right. But this does not look like an athlete that's on the rivet right now. This looks like an athlete that's pushing within his tempo, within his an effort that he's capable of sustaining for a longer period of time. So I assume that we're going to get an acceleration. Wondering or not whether or not, Michael, he's looking at that course record and knows that he's going to be within a couple minutes. But look at this as an absolute fighter. This guy, every time he got a smell of the front of the race on the bike ride, he absolutely hammered it and tried to do what he could. Now he's in second place. trying to hang on to make sure he gets second, and he's still trying to win. He is absolutely trying to put himself in a position to pounce because he is a confident man, and the fight that is in that Canadian athlete is unparalleled.
That's right. And so as we look at this and we see that he's kind of coming in on that, let's start to run the numbers once again. 8:03:56 is the men's course record. This man has that record in the realm of capability.
Oh, yeah.
Scrolling back to some exciting action right here, Sarah Crowley, and that is Heather Jackson. What have we got going on here? Because it was the other way around earlier. Sarah Crowley in front of Heather Jackson. Heather Jackson, last year's third place. This is the battle. So we've got third and fourth on the road, knowing Lucy Charles is still just a tick up the road. So behind two, we keep hearing about Kaisa Sali,
yep,
really running fast in either of these two athletes as we watch Patrick Langa take that right turn. I'm betting, $25. He doesn't cramp a hamstring, but this is the spot you talked about. Let's see how he glides down that hill.
Yeah, I mean, if you can have any good forward lean, I know you don't like the forward lean so much, Michael, but if you can have good proper form at this distance, at this time in the marathon here at the Ironman World Championships, you are an elite runner, and you're on a good pace. I mean, right now, as you said, he's almost got 9 minutes to be able to get down this hill around the corner and back down Elite E Drive, and I think you'll see a kick when he sees the clock and he gets that energy from Elite E Drive. The energy on Elite E Drive is something that you can't feel anywhere else on the planet, and I have no idea what it feels like to come down in first place, but I imagine it's going to give him a couple seconds as he runs down that finish chute.
That's right, and he's managing this final sort of effective aid station right here on the hill. You hit that, you've got just over a mile to go. This is a quad burner. This is the toenail breaker. This is the one that makes you the most sore after the race. This is the one that really leaves a mark as if nothing else in front of you did. But certainly, this is the part that is going to really crush you. And Patrick Langa just passing that zone, that Hoka One One zone across this course. He's going to round that left turn. We did this on the bike many hours ago, and we're doing it now as this man hits the Kuakini Highway straight out to Hualalai. He takes a right turn, and then it's that famous stretch of road along Ali'i Drive. Very, very few athletes over the course of this lifetime will have the honor of running down that in first place. Patrick Langa from Germany about to have that honor.
Yeah, absolutely, and it looks like in course record time, a course record that might be hard to attain anytime soon. You know, it's not one that is broken very often. Michael, we do have a race continuing to go on behind. Obviously, we saw David McNamee pass Sebastian Keenly, but James Kunema and Terenza Bazzone running side by side right now for fifth place. So tight race by two athletes. You know, James Kunema, we've seen in a fourth place in this event before. Terenza Bazzone, we've been waiting for a long time to see him have his race, and he's on it right now. He looked fresh coming out of transition. Obviously, he's still fresh now, but the freshest of anybody on this course, it seems, is the man on our screen, Patrick Langa. He is not slowing. If anything, Michael, the closer he gets to this finish line and the further he gets away from his competitors, he just continues to put the pressure on the pedals.
Well, this is the same as Danielle Reeves last year. She was so far up front, she had the win. Right now, the win is in his possession, but Danielle Reeves did this last year. She sprinted across the finish carpet. She sprinted up the ramp and across the line. She didn't stop when she hit the timing mat. She kept going. Why? Perhaps she really wanted to push that mark down, and she did so in 8:46. Today, this man has the opportunity to take down Craig Alexander's record. He's still getting sugar, caffeine by way of the cola. We saw him grab Gatorade Endurance on that final stretch. This man is very smart because we've seen the champions, Paul Anubi Fraser, Chris Lee, even in his attempt at the top 10, not make it to the finish line the way they said. The crawl, we've seen footage of that. Wendy Ingram and Sean Welch, each of them finding those calories coming up short. This man, there's nothing getting in the way of this for him.
Absolutely not. And we wonder, you know, we ask the question, is he slowing down as he gets closer to the finish line? The answer is no. With that downhill, his average speed the last mile and a half was 5:46. Compared to Lionel Sanders, 6:34. 5:46, Michael, from miles 23 and a half to 25. That's moving, and it looks like predicted time. He's going to get the course record by somewhere around 90 seconds to 2 minutes. So Patrick Langa, I bet he gets closer to 2 minutes on that because he is accelerating all the way to Ali'i Drive, and when he sees that celebration that's waiting for him, he's going to put the sprint finish down.
Hualalai and running, he's...
He's about to take that right turn onto Hualalai. This is the Kuakini Highway, absolutely burning rubber as he gets ready. These athletes he's overtaking, to those of you not familiar with the race, those are athletes on the very first couple meters, the first mile of their race. This is him overtaking those early athletes, crossing just a couple more meters before he takes that right turn, the famed Hualalai Dry. He'll run down that, and it's just a block long as he passes the library, the Kona Library, and then he takes a right turn on to the Ali'i Drive. Taking out the sponges, perhaps learning from other past champions that finished the sponge and regretted that decision. Getting ready to do the zip early, and why not? You got to look the part. Photos are snapping now. Hualalai Drive, he's there now, and this is when the energy begins to pull and draw and pull him in. It is absolutely incredible. He is going to take a right turn, and we're almost there. Out of the shadows, Matt. He's coming, and he's going to take that right turn on Ali'i Drive. This was the old hot corner, still quite hot, I'd like to say. But when he makes this turn, it's the hallowed ground of the sport. It's the moment that you've all been waiting for. Every athlete trying to get sub 17, make that finish line under the cutoff once, Ali'i Drive, and here is Patrick Langa on that stretch of road.
Yeah, Michael, under the cutoff is one thing, but you've got an athlete, Patrick.
Matt, under the Red Bull zone, take it away.
Yeah, you've got an athlete, Patrick Langa, who was first time at this race last year, and he broke a course record and was humbled by that for the run. His second time racing, he's going to get the overall course record here, taking from Craig Alexander, so close to 8 hours. Unbelievable performance by this this athlete that is pretty fresh on the Ironman scene. But Patrick Langa, this is a time you'd want to just absorb and enjoy Ali'i Drive, but he is not doing that. He's putting his name on the record books now. Marathon record, he's going to have the overall record here pretty soon.
That's right, giving a high five, staking it up. Now is when he's enjoying that, Patrick Langa. He is there, a shout out, a blow a kiss. Last year we saw him blow a kiss to that camera, and he's doing it again, the smile. One of the cool things that we saw, and I mean, you talked to Mike Riley, talked to the camera, you talked to everyone that saw him, that was such a joyous, absolutely unbridled emotion, and it's going to happen again, but tenfold as he approaches the banyan tree. And he will have only about 300 meters to go at this point. He is almost home. High fives, slowing the pace. Not this man. He's going to run all the way to that carpet. We, when we get closer, will let him take it away on the ground. Banyan tree, and we are honing in on that finish line for this young German, third place last year, looking to make it two better this year and become our 2017 Ironman World Champion. One more zip of the zip, and he's coming home.
Year 2017 Ironman World Champion, Patrick Langa! And a new course record! Giving Mark Allen a hug! Oh, here, Mark, thank you.
Thank you.
Kitty 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 Kit
So emotional.
Here he comes. What a day this young man had from Canada. Pushing the pace all day long. He had the guts to come out there and take this race to everybody. Thanking each other. Congratulations. Not a better sight than in the world.
Patrick, we've seen a lot of emotion at the finish line over the years, but I think you just bottled up about 10 years of it. It's almost like you can't believe it, but it's true. You're a world champion.
No. Oh, man, God. That's... It's everything I ever dreamed of, and I literally can't cry. It's not true. So great. Oh my God. Oh God.
Well, it is true.
Oh, right.
And I don't know if this is sunk in yet.
Oh yeah, that's right. This is their lane.
But you just broke
the
course record by Craig Alexander.
So I apologize to Crowley.
No apology needed.
He was out there on the highway, and we're friends. And he believed in me when we raced 70.3 Subic Bay, and he said, "You're gonna win it." And I said, "No, I don't think so." I honestly cannot believe it, especially. That guy over here, he's wearing the soccer jersey of my hometown club. And when I started the run, he said, "Johnny is with you." Johnny is a little child dying on leukemia, and he was the big sports.
Well, let's bring him in. Here, let's bring him. Go ahead, Paul.
Ladies and gentlemen on the finish line, can you welcome David McNamee, Great Britain?
Coming from behind.
What a run from David McNamee. You are an Ironman, at the Ironman World Championship.
Just had a look at the top three of the 2017 Ironman World Championship, a course record for one Patrick Lenga, from third place last year to first place this year in style, 2:39.59. Are you kidding me? 8:01.40. Still not under 8 hours, but darn close. And now we're looking at Keenle coming home in fourth, but Patrick Lenga from Germany, Lionel Sanders, in an impressive fight, closing out with 2:51, Matt, 8:04, just 10 seconds off the course record. At this point, that man is primed for greatness on this course. David McNamee, 13th place last year, 11th the year before, but now
podium for the Brit.
Yeah, you run a 2:45 in the 8:07 and you get third place. That's crazy. I mean, these guys are absolutely hauling out there. Lionel Sanders, 2:51. Patrick Lang has never run over 2:40 on the Ironman World Championships course. That's quite a fact there, but unbelievable racing by these guys. And look at Sebastian Kienle, you know, coming down the finish chute here in just a few minutes. He's going to be 8:10, under 8:10 in fourth place. The men's field today absolutely took advantage of these conditions, and